To the casual observer, rock fishing appears to be incredibly dangerous. And of course, you have to ask yourself, just what is it that attracts people to risk life and limb just for a feed of fish? That's what it's all about. Beautiful blackfish. And the equipment I'm using here today, centerpin reel, long rod, float, and greenweed. Now this equipment, and this is the really interesting part, this equipment can be traced right back to the core streams of England in the 1800s. Oh, yep, we're on.
There's the old adage that when you catch a fish, you don't actually catch a fish, the fish catches you.
Very much a working class tradition that a bloke would always have a veggie patch. Wouldn't buy greens, it was unheard of. And in for someone who was a fisherman, you wouldn't buy fish either, completely unheard of.
Every bloke in the street was going off blackfishing, which he could do. It was an art, and he could do it. People in a different social strata, they used to say that you could never find a barrister after about the 20th of December because they'd all packed up their trout rods and were headed off down into the snowy.
And his story is a very important one because Bruce is a living witness to the days when people lived in rock caves in Sydney Harbour during the Depression.
They're cheap, sustainable protein for the people who enjoy fresh, local Australian seafood. It's not as trendy as a snapper or a barramundi or anything like that.
Someone once said, if you give someone a fish, you'll feed them once. But if you teach someone to fish, you'll feed them for a lifetime. And the lifetime feed will be more than just human sustenance. It'll be a feeding of the spirit.